fever. There was hysteria. There was sweaty, upset crowd.
When we split up, I thought that ABBA would be completely forgotten in a couple of years. You know, that they would play the odd song on the odd radio show every now and then. But that was that.
Waterloo! How good now, little one, the world!
But then something happened towards the end of the 80s. Suddenly, the record sales went rocketing again.
Benny and Bjorn, they're the greatest songwriting team of all times. Their music is even more clean and orderly than Lennon and McCartney.
Mamma mia, here I go again. Mama, how can I weather you? Mamma mia.
I see myself as the next generation to ABBA. I mean, I'm writing my own songs, but I mean, spiritually, I'm Bjorn and Benny's soul.
Knowing me, knowing you.
There's nothing we can do.
If I had to choose between ABBA and my family,
ABBA would run a close second.
Yeah, they'd be neck and neck.
She's my good luck charm. So, please, I'm begging you to contact me. Please, if you're watching, please.
The fact that there is an audience still out there and fans still out there after 25 years is incredible, amazing. I have to pinch myself every day, really. The songs from the beginning of our career, from 73 and 5 years onwards, were kind of more teenage-oriented, more sounded younger, whereas they got more mature towards the end.
My name is Justin Kamer. I'm 13 years old, and I eat, sleep, and breathe ABBA. Every 5 minutes I think about them. It's ridiculous. For the past year and a half, not 5 minutes go by where I don't think about it. It's almost kind of a ridiculous obsession. Every day I mention it. Every day I look at a picture of them. Every day I see them. I listen to ABBA every day. I mean, just anytime someone mentions music or someone mentions band or music or anything, I think of ABBA. I think of them, ABBA singing. ABBA this, ABBA that.
Sometimes it does kind of get on our nerves. It's definitely the music that we weren't into or interested in probably at any time in our life.
My parents tell me that I shouldn't be, but I'm strictly ABBA.
We said they can be your favorite band, and that's great, but we really would like to see him listen to other music, and yeah. Justin doesn't listen to anything else, just ABBA.
She wants me to get into other bands, but I can't. It's not something I can do right now.
When I was growing up, it was Aerosmith.
And we're going to see them November 17th, yeah.
I don't listen to any other music. It's like I feel like I'm enslaved under them. It's like I feel like I'm under their power. I can't leave them.
He did it with The Wizard of Oz. Right. When he first saw The Wizard of Oz, it became an obsession. Then the Titanic, that was like a major thing for a while. Then Grease, he saw Grease, and then that was a major thing. But this definitely.
Yeah, this tops it all.
This,
ABBA was the thing.
He had never talked to me about ABBA. He had never mentioned that to me before. But I was impressed because I know the group is good. They've just appeared in Boston, not they, but they've had a musical with their music in Boston, which has been a huge hit.
The three most important things in my life are God is definitely number one, and my family is definitely number two, and number three, ABBA.
But I think Justin is seriously looking for answers in life and wants to grow up in a world that's filled with peace and love. I would love to sit down with Justin and go over some ABBA CDs. I certainly would.
ABBA's definitely an escape for me. When I get home, in my own little world, it's all I want to really listen to. I'm not Mr. Popular, but maybe because it's happy music, that's probably what takes me to another world, is because it's so happy. He's one in a million for a 13-year-old.
He's definitely unique.
He's different, yeah.
He's his own person. He's not led by others.
No.
He's definitely a leader.
But he's a leader.
Yeah.
Is there hope for me to play those?
Yeah.
If I build my way in.
He practices 8 hours a day for the neck. No.
The kids at school, they tease the hell out of me. It's ridiculous. It stinks. But then again, they do that to every kid, too. So, you know, the in crowd.
I was never in the, how does Justin always go?
The in crowd.
Popular. He always does that. Popular.
When I'm at school, I know people talk behind my back, and I'm sure they do a lot of other people too, and it hurts people's feelings.
It's not like he deals with any hurtful feelings because of ABBA. He's dealt with them just because of the way he is, an individual. And when you're an individual, sometimes.
Hello, I'm Tiffany Kamer. Like ABBA.
Last year, his locker was full of ABBA pictures.
It still is.
He just had to drag it over his locker last year. Yeah.
Most kids are interested in, like, pop and, like, Britney Spears and all that stuff. He's interested in what he wants, and he doesn't care what anybody thinks about him.
Yeah.
And, like, this thing with ABBA, it's like his life. I mean, it's just like he expresses himself so much through what he does.
He's, like, a role model to other kids. I mean, you can like what you want. It doesn't have to be, like, you don't have to like what your friends want you to. You can like whatever you want.
He doesn't care.
All about ABBA.
Oh,
nothing but ABBA.
I don't know where it comes from, but he just has this appreciation for it. Now I have to go find out about ABBA because I'm not too sure about it, you know. I'm not sure it's really on his mind all the time.
To seal the leaves, devant.
I'm the principal, so I don't know whether he's, you know, sharing everything with me, because I would have known that it's every moment of his waking life. Do you remember?
What? Justin?
I think I missed something. You know, there was something out there for me, and I've found it, and there's nothing else out there that will capture me like ABBA captured me.
I think at one point or another, I think all of us have in our life something that we're obsessed with to some degree, you know? And I'd rather have ABBA than drugs or hanging out in the street and doing the wrong things.
I know me, and I know what I am, and no one else can tell me what to do. And no one else can tell me that ABBA stinks, because ABBA does not stink one little bit. Because, you know, when you go and read the books, ABBA is definitely the best-selling group of the 70s. I mean, this is something that it'll be my favorite till I take it to the grave.
Forgiving it to me.
ABBA will never be taken off my number one spot. They'll always be the number one for me.
This is where we have a bonfire every Yule.
We bring out, pour up the set, and put all the songs on them. So when we go around the bonfire, we do it to ABBA music.
We dance around it, say some words to our ancestors, and let it burn.
He's a fireman and a Jared fan from Subway. He got real big on burgers and fries. Now he's down to a smaller size. Gets his mite from his veggie delight. Great taste each day from his local Subway.
He's Henry Clay Henry.
With X
exercise in a diet including Subway's 7 delicious sandwiches with 6 grams of fat or less. People like Clay Henry are inspirations for everyone.
Subway, eat fresh.
Proud sponsor of the American Heart Association's Heart Walk.
Most popular pop group of the 70s is back. ABBA, the definitive collection. Seven of ABBA's greatest hits on an amazing 2-CD set. ABBA, the definitive collection. Over 2 hours of classic ABBA on 2 CDs. Call now to order your copy of ABBA, the definitive collection. 37 amazing tracks on 2 CDs. You've seen the play. Now you can get all the original classic ABBA hits on this 2-CD set. ABBA, the definitive collection, includes 2 bonus tracks, previously unreleased remixes of their biggest hits. The only ABBA collection you'll ever need. The definitive collection includes a deluxe 32-page booklet featuring detailed commentary, liner notes, and rare photos of ABBA. The first compilation of all of ABBA's biggest hits, digitally remastered to modern standards. What's the name of the game? Honey, honey, how you 2 CDs, 37 of your favorite ABBA songs, heard as they were meant to be heard. The definitive collection, yours for only $24.98. Call the number on your screen to order your copy of ABBA, the definitive collection, and the 2 bonus remix tracks, or send check or money order for $24.98 for 2 CDs plus $4.95 shipping and handling to the address shown. Order now!
Oh, my head.
Wish you could undo what you did last night? Introducing new Alka-Seltzer Morning Relief, a special combination of ingredients to relieve your pounding head and give you a burst of energy. Alka-Seltzer Morning Relief. Feel better than you should.
Believe the unbelievable. Think the unthinkable. And prepare to face your darkest fear. For two men are about to confront pure evil. This January, discover the secret of the Brotherhood of the Wolf. Rated R. At select theaters this Friday.
You want to make a collect call? Dial down the center. It's 1-800-C-A-L-L-A-T-T. It's free for you and cheap for them.
Two men are bad acting.
Well, at least I know how to skate.
Save big bucks on every call. Just dial 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
Club Med. Wanna play?
If you change your mind,
take a chance
on the first in line.
Take a chance,
honey, I'm still free.
Take a chance,
take a chance on me.
If I had a bad day or if I had a bad week, yeah, I could play ABBA and I'd just feel on top of the world.
She's kind of become a fan out of necessity to live in the house.
I think they're the greatest group that ever lived.
I know, but that music is like
everyone likes ABBA.
Why is it that the music is so much alive still after 25 years? I can only think it's the quality of the songs. I mean, we put so much work into that. Also, of course, the sound of the two girls together is quite unique. The Frida is a kind of a mezzo, and Agnetha is a true soprano. And when Frida tries to get up to Agnetha's level, creates a very, very special sound. And still, it doesn't sound dated. It still sounds kind of energetic and fresh.
Hi, my name is Wayne Beisman. Here in Harris, Minnesota. It's about 50 miles due north of the Twin Cities. Population,
Around 800, 900 people. Everybody in here is at least part Swedish. We have a laundromat down there, a post office, a bank behind you, and of course, Barbara Jean's. That's a local bar and strip joint here. We have a taxidermist place here also. It's been here a couple, 3 years. I'm the city councilman here. I was elected, I think, with 186 votes. Let's see. Hi, Sally. How you doing? Yes, I love this land. My parents bought it 50 years ago, and that's when my brother died in the Korean War. My parents used the money to buy this farm, so I have a feeling it'll never be sold as long as I'm living, and hopefully long after I die. This is pretty much like it is in Sweden. This farm is exactly as tall. These are pine trees, but they're called tall in Sweden, and I've got oak trees, elk, ek, and birch trees. Those are all wild raspberries over there, by the way.
This is Little Sweden. If you've ever been to Sweden, right, this is Little Sweden.
Open the door. And up here is my Abba shrine. It's about 400 square feet of nothing but Abba. Got the Swedish flag, of course, and got all sorts of posters here. As you notice, all along here I have books. Plus, I have maybe 50, 60, 45s. Over here are the t-shirts that Agneta and Honor Freed wore in one of their concerts. I bought that in Stockholm last year. I guess I spent maybe between $5,000 and $10,000. And by the way, this is about 80% of what I have. I have a lot more that I just couldn't get in. This is my kind of a temple. It really is. Instead of organ music or Amazing Grace, I have Thank You for the Music on. First time I heard ABBA was on the radio in 1974. Honey, Honey was the first song I heard about then. And I saw them in Dick Clark about 1975, and then I really got into it. I bought all their records. 1980, I saw their concert on PBS, and I was hooked completely then, because just the way they performed their concert. From then on, I really became a huge fan. Oh, we have a tattoo parlor. Well, we have a new business, a tattoo parlor here.
You would give me an ABBA tattoo.
You betcha.
How much do you charge?
Half price.
Half price. You do faces, pictures like this?
You bet.
Oh, good. Okay, we haven't done the ABBA yet. Well, maybe we can get... I don't know if I want to go that far. I don't know.
Not that big of a fan, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, maybe I could do that, though. I think, wouldn't that be something if I did had an ABBA tattoo? Let me think about that a while before I do it, though. Before I make an ABBA tattoo. Let me think.
Yeah, the ABBA dolls we have on display are actually, these are four of 340 dolls made by a Swedish artist. Maybe you recognize some of the outfits.
Yeah, this looks exactly like a old-time Swedish costume. And she did wear one, I know that. Well, that's good, but it's the only ABBA thing you have here.
Well, it's the only thing we have right now.
We have to change that. Hail ABBA! Hail ABBA! ABBA den Storch Musiker Gruppen! Sometimes I put the ABBA LP when I'm working in my garden or pruning my trees. Turn it up as high as I can. And about ready to do a pressing here. Right now, the farm, now it's named Midgard, which is Middle Kingdom, Middle Farm. I'm thinking about renaming the ABBA Gord, which means ABBA Farm.
The skull, ABBA.
I think what set ABBA apart from the other acts during the 70s was our musical influences when we grew up, Benny and me. Any Anglo-Saxon composer, or most of them, wouldn't have listened to the music that we listened to, because we listened to German Schlager, you know, Italian ballads and French ballads, and because in Swedish radio, all of that was played all the time, you know, a mixture of everything. Whereas an American just would have listened to American music, I think.
I think ABBA music is just a continuation of the old, you know, traditional music.
Times of joy.
favorite ABBA song is Like Old Friends Do. And that says that I think we're right here. It's family and friends in times of joy and times of sorrow. Our friendship always see us through. We will get through together the way old friends do. That could very well be sung 150 years ago. And this is what it's all about here. We're all friends and family here. I just love their music. It makes my day. I mean, it's just, I could live without them. I'm not obsessed with them. I don't stalk them. I don't do anything like that. But it just adds a little extra special to my life. Makes my life a little bit better.
I'd never gone to a concert with a tribute band. But I hear a lot about them, and they're everywhere.
You know the weirdest thing about this band, ABBA? They have the same names as us.
It can get confusing, yes. Can't it?
I've never been in the audience. I think that would be very weird.
Okay, they've got a new album. A new song stuck in my head. Can't stop singing it. And they're about to hit the road.
Big tour. Creed. Join VH1 opening night to kick off the 2002 Creed Tour. Wednesday, January 16th at 9, 8 central. Till then, go to VH1.com for tour info and everything Creed.
Oh, yeah.
Sponsored by Club Med.
We'll call you personally. To enter, just log on. Check out rate plans starting at $19.99, and singular customers can download cool Sugar Ray ringtones.
I'm gonna be late for me own wedding.
No worries.
My new Subaru Outback's more stable in a turn than a Lexus RX 300. Gets better gas mileage than a Ford Explorer. And like every Subaru, has the added traction of all-wheel drive.
Subaru Outback, the world's first sport utility wagon.
The rugged outdoorsy type. Nice choice.
Now you can get an APR as low as 2.9% on all 2002 Outback models.
The Victoria's Secret semi-annual sale is on now, with bras starting at just $9.99, panties at $2.99. Save on sleepwear, hosiery, even beauty products. It's the Victoria's Secret semi-annual sale, and you've just got to be there.
I need you to stay in your room.
Why?
Because you're an embarrassment.
Oh, okay.
Lance is the type of big brother you can look up to.
I didn't get in.
I didn't go to college. Look at me.
And count on.
You're getting into college, buddy. I know it.
When there's absolutely no one else.
Oh, my God.
Friday.
It's been a dream of mine all my life to go to Stanford.
Cut.
Got to loosen it up, buddy.
Now listen, you gotta make love to him. Like, go, hey, what's up,
Stanford? Orange County, rated PG-13, starts Friday.
Chili.
Chili. You look downright cold.
No, a bowl of chili.
Yes! Let me get my boots, we'll go to Wendy's.
Only Wendy's 99-cent super value menu has delicious chili and hot baked potatoes. Wendy's, the best 99 cents you can spend.
Need contact lenses? You could. Get in your car, drive to your eye doctor, wait in line, pay twice as much, wait a week, drive back, pick them up. Or call 1-800-CONTACTS. We deliver, you save.
Add some value to your home with the pros on HGTV.
Whether you have a new house or an old house, it requires constant maintenance and repair.
From ideas and inspiration to hands-on renovation.
But we'll get right to it.
View it before you do it. With the pros, weeknights from 6 to 8 Eastern on HGTV, Home and Garden Television.
Get great new programming like HGTV on digital cable from Time Warner. Call today. Time Warner Cable, the very best in TV, keeps getting better.
Only Time Warner Cable delivers digital cable and Roadrunner high-speed online.
I get more channels with stars and everything I want online instantly.
Crystal clear digital picture and sound.
I'm
I'm always connected to all the internet has to offer.
What are you wearing?
We don't tie up the phone line when we're online.
I get it all. Time Warner, Digital TV, and Roadrunner. Simple.
Time Warner Cable, the very best in TV, keeps getting better.
Ridiculous offer every second year or something to reunite. The latest offer we had, which you probably heard of, was $1 billion, and we actually sat down and discussed this. You know, should we, shouldn't we? But came to the conclusion for various reasons that we should not do it. We were supposed to play 100 concerts during 1 year. And I thought to myself, how can I face that? Because they're bound to be disappointed. You know, they remember us as we were, but they would get four 50-year-olds playing that music, but without that youthful energy. So, no way. We are the group that never came back.
Well, I'm Benny from Bjorn Again.
And I am Bjorn, also, funnily enough, from Bjorn Again.
My name is Agnetha.
I am Frida.
And we are Bjorn Again.
When we came up with the idea to do an ABBA show, I thought it was absolutely barking mad. Because I thought, it's long forgotten, and if we get up on stage with all that gear and do ABBA songs, we'll probably get bricks thrown at us. I was quite worried about it, actually.
There's a real void of entertaining shows back in the mid to late 80s. So it seemed totally appropriate to do it. Let's start an ABBA band, you know, just really as a fun thing to do.
Plus you had the two girls, the two boys, they were Swedish, which is sort of like Martians to Australians. And it was just, the songs were sort of the ultimate dripping tap songs. Once you heard them, you just couldn't get them out of your mind. And I think a strange stat I heard was that more people watched an ABBA special on television in Australia than the first lunar landing.
It's as close as we can get to seeing ABBA these days, and I think they're so true to ABBA, it's untrue. I mean, they even have the Swedish accents when they're on stage. They look like ABBA, they sound like ABBA, they dress like ABBA, they dance like ABBA.
It's very uplifting, and you know, you just want to move your feet and you want to dance and you want to be smiling, and it's just carefree.
Too young to have appreciated ABBA when they were big, and then obviously I've got to know Bjorn Again and more of the ABBA music through that. I just like the music, just think it's good, uplifting music.
Out of 7 or 8 years, we only spent half a year touring. I mean, if you spend too much time on the road, it's very difficult to write when you're touring. We found impossible. And in this business, everything begins and ends with a song anyway, so why bother?
A very happy new year to all our Dutch viewers.
The first contact we had from ABBA was in 1990, I think.
From Bjorn? Bjorn sent a telegram, and he was completely flattered by what we were doing, you know, because we thought it might have been backfired on us.
They couldn't believe that there was a band in Australia impersonating ABBA and with the Swedish accents and all that sort of stuff. They just thought it was some weird cult thing happening in Australia.
And he was a bit miffed at the accents, you know, talking about the Swenglish accents.
Yeah, but when he said, "I don't speak like that," you know, sort of, well, yes, you do, actually.
Exactly what you sound like.
Hey, Benny, can I play some rock and roll?
We wanted to carry the humour on stage to off stage. So when we're doing interviews or whatever, the band were always in character and in Swedish accent.
You wear the flares.
I've seen bigger flares than that on you.
I know. I'm
small ones
feeling
today.
Fairly conservative today.
You know, no, keep it simple, keep it satin. Not too bright, not too glittery. No.
They are small.
So because the last gig I actually fell over, then they got tucked up in my shoe, and I fell down and hurt my knee. So I thought that I should wear smaller flares today.
Okay, we've heard enough.
When we started the band, we researched heavily, you know, whatever ABBA material we could get, platform shoes,
scrapbooks,
you know, trying to get the look right.
Plus great production values with PA lights, costumes, the whole works. Plus people ask, now which couple was with who?
Agneta and Bjorn were an item, they were married, and ultimately Benny and Frida got married. So we play up on that period where Bjorn and Agneta, they've gotten together, but there's a bit of a thing going on with Benny and Frida.
Agneta and Bjorn are very much in love, which is lovely.
Yeah, we are very happy.
Not the same with you and Benny, though, is it?
Yeah, well, me and Frida, we're very much in love, too.
But it's not strictly true, is it, Benny?
No, he likes me, but I don't want to know. No.
ABBA fan and Bjorn Again fan, it's sort of something of a void in their life. They love that music, they play that music on their CD player at home, and to see it played live is something else. I mean, we noticed that with Bjorn Again, sort of in a way representing ABBA, they're massive fans of Bjorn Again as well.
Actually, we get a lot of Japanese tourists, and you can imagine, like, everyone, ABBA! So they streamed out of this bus thinking we were ABBA, and I had to go to one of them to say, look, we're actually not ABBA.
Hi. Hello. How are you?
Okay. You well?
Good. So you're all fond of the music then?
No.
Yeah? Oh, that's good.
We do come across so many people whose lives completely and utterly revolve around ABBA. This is like the closest we're going to get to ABBA is Bjorn Again. So we'll just worship you because we don't know how to worship them anymore. They're not around.
So would you like to sing a little song with us now?
If you change your mind, I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. Gonna be around. If you got no place to go, put your feelings out.
The range of people who like ABBA music is from little kids to really old people, everyone in between. And from all nationalities and walks of life, absolutely worshipping us as well. So along with that mass of people, you get obsessed fans, and we get them.
Towards the end of the 80s, people started to record our songs again, and there were a couple of films, Muriel's Wedding, and things happening at the same time, a kind of revival happening. I never understood why, but I could see it happening. The songs really came back, and I'm still to this day fascinated by it. I cannot explain why.
My name is Belinda. I live in Las Vegas. Today is my birthday. For all of you that are not listening to ABBA, you're missing out. Seriously. Las Vegas is a very fun town. It's not just gambling that draws people here. It's amazing. It's entertaining. There's entertainment of all kinds. When I drive around Las Vegas, I think of the ABBA song, Money, Money, Money. Because that's what this town is all about. Money, money, money. It's a rich man's world. I come from a family of collectors. We all collect, and we all have these, I don't want to say obsessions, but I mean, come on, let's not kid ourselves here. It's like a game almost. What can you get? What can you find that somebody else doesn't have, maybe?
Welcome to my ABBA room. This is my Agneta wall. She's my favorite. This is my license plate off my car. These are the ABBA magazines. These are my ABBA clogs. I used to call these my ABBA boots, and I used to wear them to work. These are different picture discs. This is a Japanese program from ABBA the movie. This is my mom, Pat, and this is my brother, Nick.
When she goes for something, she goes gung-ho. And when she came home with an ABBA tape from a party, I about fell over.
We're not on the same wavelength.
I don't know. I somehow missed ABBA along the way because I like music, and I've always, you know, been into different kinds of music, but never really got into ABBA.
I like Marvin Gaye, but not ABBA. I like POD, but not ABBA. I like Jim Croce, but not ABBA.
I'm not the only one with, you know, some compulsion. I know someone who had a Thriller jacket or two. ABBA? ABBA. This is where I work, and I work for MGM Mirage. And I work for the corporate retail division. I chose to be in the corner because they're, you know, I annoy people.
It's very true that they stuck her in the corner because of ABBA. Because of ABBA, because she plays it loud and she sings it loud.
I'm in my own world, which I like.
It was always, you know, whose music was going to win out. And it was generally always Dancing Queen. Dancing Queen always won. It was always ABBA.
Hi, Belinda.
Hello.
Always liked ABBA. Great group. A lot of fun.
Yeah.
Super.
Pretty much I listen to it throughout the day. And I keep their pictures up so they're here every day. It's lonely to be an ABBA fan, but if there was no ABBA, I'd just be lost, I guess. I just like being able to take pictures. It's a way of expressing yourself. I mean, I don't base my entire life on ABBA because then you're really being set up for disappointment. No matter what that one thing is. When you're out in a place like this, you're very insignificant, and that means that your daily problems are very insignificant because you're in something that's so much more grand than you as an individual. I just believe if you want something, you should have it. And that doesn't necessarily mean, you know, everybody wants $1 million. But I mean, if there's something logical that you want, then if you want it bad enough, there's no reason why you really can't have that.
Is that you or what?
Go ahead. Hi. She hates ABBA.
Yeah.
I don't understand her music. She doesn't understand mine. I get that from her.
So we keep music out of our relationship, basically. No, ABBA's fine. I have no problem with ABBA. I have no problem with music in general. I love music in general. So it's all good. If I have to listen to it to be around her, I will. Not a problem.
So all for the camera.
She wishes she could be flown to Sweden.
What I feel that people remember us by is that the music somehow is kind of uplifting. Something that makes you feel good when you listen to it. And also nostalgia. I mean, 70s is really nostalgia now. And ABBA is part of the 70s in a, you know, in a very evident way.
I wouldn't create music without ABBA. I wouldn't think of writing music without Frida on my mind. It's like inspiration. I mean, it's like inside me. I don't know. I cannot do without that.
This new year, Iggy Pop's gonna keep his pants on, Meatloaf's gonna drop a few pounds, and P. Diddy's gonna behave. Well, VH1's got a New Year's resolution we can keep. Behind the Music at a new time, every night at 8, 7 Central, only on VH1.
I wish I could have an organic experience.
You've never had one?
I love herbal essences, but I need intense conditioning.
Honey, meet your new best friend.
Herbal Essences Intensive Blends, creamier, vitamin enriched, improves hair's condition up to 85%.
It's our first time.
Work it! Woo!
Herbal Essences Intensive Blends.
Guys, the bottle says repeat. Hello?
Collect calls.
Did you use 1-800-COLLECT?
No!
1-800-COLLECT presents Ava Save-A-Lot, starring in the most horrifying movie ever. I know you're not calling me with 1-800-COLLECT.
What kind of twist of mind wouldn't want me to save a buck or two? It's so easy. What a nightmare.
1-800-COLLECT, save a buck or two.
Best Supporting Actress.
She likes to work for. She's a snobbish cow.
Ooh, yum.
Best Screenplay.
I was just wondering if she wanted some company.
Well, I suppose life must go on.
Best Director. And Best Picture of the Year.
Look, he's a murderer.
I'm horrid.
Gosford Park, nominated for 5 Golden Globe Awards.
Tough luck on whoever's got any secrets to hide.
This holiday season, join the party of the year.
Perhaps the butler did it.
Gosford Park, rated R. Now playing at select theaters.
Monistat introduces the One Dose Ovule, a soft gel insert that's part of the new Monistat One combination pack, which means relief starts immediately. Not so with that prescription pill. For today's women, fast relief means Monistat.
The Victoria's Secret semi-annual sale is on now, with bras starting at just $9.99, panties at $2.99. Save on sleepwear, hosiery, even beauty products. It's the Victoria's Secret semi-annual sale, and you've just got to be there.
I'm feeling good. I'm taking Wellbutrin SR, an antidepressant with a low risk of sexual side effects. That's important to me.
Wellbutrin SR is clinically proven to effectively treat depression with a low risk of sexual side effects.
Glad I talked to my doctor. Wellbutrin SR works for my depression.
Be open with your doctor. Ask about Wellbutrin SR. It treats depression with a low risk of sexual side effects.
Wellbutrin SR is not for everyone. There is a risk of seizure. To reduce that risk, don't use if you have or have had a seizure or eating disorder. Don't use if you take Zyban or an MAOI. When used with a nicotine patch or alone, there is a risk of increased blood pressure, sometimes severe. To reduce risk of serious side effects, tell your doctor if you have liver or kidney problems. Other side effects may include dry mouth, nausea, and difficulty sleeping.
I'm feeling like myself again.
Ask your doctor about Wellbutrin SR, clinically proven to treat depression with a low risk of sexual side effects.
Burger King introduces the new Hickory Bacon Cheddar Burger. Flame broiled beef, topped with smoked cheddar cheese, 3 strips of sizzling bacon, onions, and creamy barbecue sauce. Get a single for 99 cents. A double for $1.49, a triple $1.99. The new Hickory Bacon Cheddar Burger. Have it your way, only at Burger King. Now for a limited time.
Olay invites you to take a picture of yourself, because after using anti-aging Total Effects, your skin may never look the same. It gives you better results faster than these leading department store products. Instantly, tone and color improve. The look of age spots diminishes, and it keeps working to fight 7 signs of aging. So why just shoot for the future? Picture yourself looking younger starting today. Total Effects from Olay, the faster way to love the skin you're in.
Towards the end of ABBA's career, Benny and I were more and more attracted to doing something theatrical. So when we felt that the energy went out of the group, it was natural for us to go towards musicals. And we got in touch with Tim Rice, and we wrote Chess. I don't think we could write a song like SOS anymore. Where are those heads we gave? They seem so hard to find. Because that was part of our career at that time. So that music reflects who we were then. And now, I love working in the theater.
My name is Ayhan Shahin. I want to be in the musical theater business. And I'm very much obsessed in ABBA. I think ABBA is very spiritual. And the more I explored in their music, the more I found. The harmonies, the layers in it are so intense that every time you listen, you get a new idea. I see myself as the next generation to ABBA. I mean, I'm writing my own songs. Spiritually, I'm Björn and Benny's soul. I'm not talking about covering their music. I'm writing new original songs, because there are lots of acts who are covering ABBA's songs and who are becoming celebrities. I'm not one of them. I just believe in my music. I just believe in my talents. And it's a fortunate thing that I can mix my talents with Björn and Benny's spirit, which brings out a fabulous thing for me. It's been a summer,
the union's over. We are rehearsing for a performance next week, a song from my musical inspired by ABBA that's called Swedish Style,
which was based on ABBA's career, their professional lives, and their becoming immortals in music literature. Well, it's better than to bury
ABBA's soul. Ayhan's passion for ABBA music definitely helps him create new stuff. And it brings more inspiration for his life and for his musical creation. It's based on his love to ABBA music.
I had the pleasure of meeting Benny and Björn in 95 with the help of the Swedish embassy. I was producing my show Swedish Style, and they had arranged a meeting with Björn and Benny and me so that I could present my work to them. And when I met them, it was amazing, because it was the highest point in my life. It was my dream coming true. I have a
dream. This is where I live, Brooklyn Heights, right across the river to Manhattan, and we are going to take a look around the neighborhood, the promenade we are going to. I have a dream, a song to sing. And here is the Brooklyn Bridge.
I want to be in the musical theater business, and I believe that New York is the perfect place for my aim. Because I had my dreams, which I still believe will one day come true, that I will publish my works. Everybody will listen to my music. That's my dream, and that's why I came here. I believe in
angels. Sometimes I just sit here and watch the lights in Manhattan, and it kind of resembles the opportunities and my dreams becoming true. And I know that one of the lights just shining there is just for me. I know that I will reach that light and make my dreams come true. I have a
dream. Ayhan was writing a song last night, and he told me that he had to go into the music room and conjure Frida's music, but I know it's not always just so he can sing along. I know that it's partly to inspire a particular mood that he's delivering in the music that he writes.
I'm a fan of ABBA. He's a fan of Sheena Easton.
See, Sheena Easton, it's all about the purity of the voice.
I still think ABBA is, of course, bigger.
I think that's the same with Frida. I mean, when she sings, she's just pure, and she's just right with the feelings of the lyric.
But there's lyrics.
But it's pop songs. I mean, in pop songs, nobody pay attention about the lyrics.
But you should also be able to have very,
that's what ABBA is,
very pensive moments. Fernando, Dancing Queen, you know, I've never cried to those songs. Knowing me, knowing you.
When I listen to ABBA, I escape from my everyday life and I totally concentrate on my spirit. And as a composer, it's the best thing for me. It's like school, because whenever I need new inspiration or whenever I'm looking for a different thing, I still listen to the same music and I get new things and I get new inspirations from them.
You don't see why, as hard as you try, you're not one of them.
It's kind of a progression I want to use.
We're both interested in writing a pop musical, whether or not I know the names of the people who write pop musicals. I think Ihan definitely represents the pop sound. That's part of why I wanted to work with him, is because my writing, I consider it to be modern and today. I love that hook at the opening of the chorus. That's the best part.
We're just friends, or how long?
That part. Oh, it's great.
Okay, because this is representing their wish to be escaped, I mean, to be abducted by those aliens.
I think the biggest sign that Ihan was obsessed with ABBA is the fact that he wanted to write a musical about Freya.
About who?
The singer, what's her name?
Frida. Oh, you don't even know.
See,
Frida.
It shows how much I know ABBA.
Where are those happy days? They seem so hard to find. I mean, it's all like three chord progression. It used to be so nice. It used to be so good.
And that's the kind of music we're going to write.
Yeah, exactly. Full key and simple.
And I never even knew that song was ABBA. I see my research is about to begin.
I always admired ABBA as a group a lot, though I can't imagine that I feel that their spirit inhabits me, but their work is really wonderful, and the fact that Ihan connected with that so dramatically himself was a point of connection for us.
All right, everybody, so we're going to start. I guess we'll do two, and then take a break, and then do two. And we'll start with Ihan and Sean. Cool.
So many uncaring. I'm in the process of writing my thesis project, and the people who know ABBA were telling me that, okay, your music sounds like them. It's not copying them, but the style, the genre is really the same.
Ihan immediately connects with the emotional. That's what he goes for. He has a tremendous melodic gift.
I wouldn't create music without ABBA. I wouldn't think of writing music without Frida on my mind. It's like inspiration. I mean, it's like inside me. I don't know. I cannot do without that.
The four members of ABBA are queens and kings, and you know, they all live this special life that we love to follow. Every little thing that happens is interesting to us, and we're here to show our appreciation of ABBA.
Hey, Dan,
how about that conference call tomorrow?
Just doesn't feel right to me. Whatever happened to FaceTime? Somebody should go to Cleveland. I'll go.
This wouldn't have anything to do with Holiday Inn Express double points.
No. What? I don't even know where that came from.
When I get back in Cleveland, we'll talk.
Here's your large pizza and free cine sticks.
Thanks.
Hey guys, our large pizza's here. And the Domino's guy said the cine sticks are free. Then he said, I have to eat them all. Right in front of him. Or they wouldn't be free.
He's not allowed to get the door anymore.
Topped with cinnamon sugar and served with creamy icing, it's Domino's freshly baked Zena Sticks. Get a free order when you buy any large one-topping pizza for $9.99. Call now. Get the door. It's Domino's.
I wanna be hugged by you.
Introducing a body wash that hugs your skin as it softens.
I wanna be hugged by you alone.
New shower-to-shower refreshing body wash. It starts as a gel. Turns into a rich lather, then rinses clean, leaving you soft and smooth. New shower-to-shower refreshing body wash.
Boo, boo, be-doo.
Hey,
Hey, you like delivery pizza? I like delivery pizza.
It's not delivery. It's French.
For fresh baked pizza at home, it's not delivery, it's DiGiorno.
You want to make a collect call, dial to the center. It's 1-800-C-A-L-L-A-T-T. It's free for you and cheap for them.
2 minutes bad acting.
Well, at least I know how to skate.
Save big bucks on every call. Just dial 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
One of the great films of all time is going away for 10 years. Hurry and buy Snow White on video and DVD before it disappears.
But it's not too late.
Because on January 31st, it's going back into the Disney Vault. Get it before it's gone.
Some home pregnancy tests aren't as clear as they could be. Thank goodness there's improved Clear Blue Easy. Now with clearer lines than any leading brand. One test is all it takes. Clear enough? Clear Blue. Clear results.
12 actors. One motivation. Making it.
That's the story of my life right now.
I'm Batman.
This is a joke.
Someone just pay me.
I feel really good. I feel like I have to get it.
Yay! Follow 12 actors in search of their big break.
I really gotta get famous. This stinks.
The It Factor. Dramatically different reality TV.
I'm making it, baby.
Series premiere Sunday, January 6th at 9 on Bravo. Now on Time Warner Cable, Channel 38.
Stop.
Only VH1 gives you the stories behind the music.
I knew as a child that music was going to take me someplace.
To get the story behind advertising your business on local cable, call Time Warner City Cable. Advertise on over 40 networks, target your best customers. They'll even produce your commercial for you, and you won't pay rock star prices.
I could go out and in 20 minutes make 20 grand.
Advertise on cable in New York City. Call Time Warner City Cable now. And for all the stories behind the music, watch VH1.
Why don't you just go and do that?
Exciting, huh?
I met them yesterday, right now I'm trying to sign them.
It's like a second ABBA career for me to travel around with Mamma Mia. It's a family-oriented, funny kind of musical based on ABBA songs.
A lot of us have seen the play. I saw it in London, Toronto, San Francisco, and Chicago. It's sort of like Deadheads for pop music. You have to listen.
I don't even know if I'm going to like the music. But who knows? Maybe by the time I come out, maybe I'm going to be a fan of the, what's it called, Baba?
ABBA.
ABBA.
Here I go again.
Is it that you have stayed fans for so long?
And we need you.
Yeah.
Hello.
It's become as a musical phenomenon as well. And to hear the songs in this context makes them songs from a musical. I don't hear them as ABBA songs anymore. They're songs from Mamma Mia.
There's a magic in ABBA music that gets these kids fired up. It's amazing.
What I like to be our legacy is that it's uplifting, something that makes you feel good when you listen to it. I don't know why there is an audience still out there and fans still out there after 25 years. I just enjoy it very, very much.
If you missed a minute of ABBA Fan Club, you can see it again tonight at 7, 6 Central. But next, the most poignant docudrama ever produced, The Jacksons, An American Dream.
And me only 17, oh yeah. You can dance, you can jive, even the time.
Wait.